your magic meter running low? Well, we've got a cure for you. Welcome to Disney Coast to Coast.
Hey, folks, and welcome to Disney Coast to Coast, the ultimate unofficial Disney fan podcast. I'm Jeff DePauly.
And I'm Patrick Dougal.
And Patrick?
Yeah.
You know what?
What?
It seems like if you want a Disney rumor to come true,
you just gotta talk about it.
All you gotta do is talk about it on Disney Coast to Coast, and it'll come
everything
true.
Will come true.
If you don't know what we're talking about, last week we had an episode all about Disney rumors, and several of them have come true since that episode.
Yeah.
It's kind of crazy, actually. So, shall we just jump into them?
Let's go.
Let's confirm the Muppets Liberty Square thing is happening.
Yeah.
Which I think we both, I honestly don't even remember, but I think we both agreed, like, probably would happen. Didn't seem that unplausible, but it's official. So let's talk details for a second. It's going to be called The Muppets Present Great Moments in American History. And of course, it's going to heavily feature Sam Eagle, which
yeah.
I think everybody expected. Kermit, Piggy, Fozzie, and Gonzo, and a character named James Jefferson, who is the town crier of Liberty Square.
Obviously.
And what do you think, human or puppet? I kind of think human.
Yeah.
Because the Muppets tend to interact with humans mm-hmm. quite a bit. So I feel like it's that James Jefferson character will be a human. And there's going to be an original song, which
Ooh.
I'm very excited about. This all starts October 2016, which means I get to see it, which makes me even more happy. They said it's going to be in front of the Hall of Presidents.
Mm-hmm.
That whole window thing that we had heard about, did we talk about that? I think so. Where I had heard there were going to be characters on second story windows.
Yeah.
Whether or not that happens, I don't know. It's going to be interesting. I still don't know how I feel about it.
This is a weird location. It's just, I don't know.
Yeah. It's,
it makes sense, but then it doesn't.
Exactly. Because the Muppets kind of make sense everywhere.
Yeah.
Like, the Muppets are these characters that were geniusly created to fit anywhere in the real world. The question is simply, is it undignified to have them in Liberty Square? But then I'm like, well, you know what? The Haunted Mansion is part of Liberty Square.
Mm-hmm.
So if the Muppets are undignified, so is the Haunted Mansion. Because, like, I think when I think Liberty Square, I just immediately think Hall of Presidents.
Yeah.
And, you know, colonial design and stuff. So
I think Poop Streets.
Oh, the Poop Street, yes. Explain.
That's the first thing I think.
If people don't know what you're...
If you walk into Liberty Square, there's one patch down the middle of the walkway that is, like, brown cobblestone.
Uh-huh.
And the other is just, like, normal paved.
And it's, like, windy, isn't it?
Yeah, it's, yeah. like, looks like a flowing river, but brown cobblestone. That is symbolizing poop. Poop water,
yeah.
pretty much, because in colonial times, when they were done, they would just toss it out the window.
Yeah, so all about the details, and if it were universal, it would smell like that, too.
Yeah.
they would pump the scent. But yeah, that's a fun fact for you there about Liberty Square. But yeah, I still don't know if I like them there,
mm-hmm.
but I'm sure I'm going to love the show. That's
yeah.
what I think is going to... That's what it's going to come down to. It's going to be interesting to see how the characters come out and stuff. Like, is there going to be a pushcart? Or are they using those second story windows? I don't know. We'll find out.
As long as they're in, like the concept they showed of them, they're in, like, colonial garb.
Yeah. The concept photos were really cool. Which I don't think those... I've never seen those costumes before of you. Like, have you seen them for the 4th of July or anything that they might have just used that photo? Or
no.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure those were created for the show. In which case, cool. And I'm really happy that it's, like, the actual Muppets, because you're probably too young, but do you remember, like, the full-on fuzzy character Muppets that used to be at Disney MGM Studios?
Only the... What's his name?
Kermit?
No. The guy...
Oh, Sweetums.
Yeah.
Sweetums. Okay, Sweetums, who's in Muppet Vision 3D. But yeah, no, like Kermit and all of them used to have full-size meet-and-greet type costumes. So
creepy.
Yeah, it was a little weird. Their mouths did move, though, way back in the day, in like the early 90s. So, in any case, that's happening. That was a rumor last week, and now it's legit.
Came true.
It came true. Yay, magic happens. Is that magic? I guess it's magic.
Sure.
Oh, boy. Anyway, Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yeah.
This one of these rumors also came true. We talked about several others as well. But the Guardians of the Galaxy Mission Breakout is the official name. We are officially losing the Tower of Terror.
NDCA.
In Disney California Adventure, yeah. It's I don't know. I'm actually kind of excited.
I'm okay with it. Everyone is like freaking. I've had very long disagreements with people over Twitter about this whole thing. Yeah. And I'm like, listen, you need to calm down. Like, people are like freaking out. I'm like, literally, we all know World has the best Tower of Terror anyway. Go.
Is it better than Tokyo's?
Well, Tokyo's not Twilight Zone.
No, I'm just asking. Do you like which one?
Oh,
do
no,
you like
I like
more?
I like Tokyo. Okay. That's another reason. I was like, hey, guess what? In my opinion, the best Tower of Terror is not even Twilight Zone.
Yeah,
it's a Hightower Hotel.
It's more, you know, it's so, tradition. Yeah. It's original. I get the upset. The faith comes with Joe Rohde. It has been announced that Joe Rohde is spearheading this Marvel thing happening
at
DC.
Trust in Joe Rohde.
I will say, though, there was a little bit of me that, like, you watched the video, yes, where he announces this project. For the first time, I felt like there was a bit of BS coming from his mouth. Like, I felt like he didn't even believe everything he was saying. And it was very, not clever, but very carefully scripted. Worded. Yeah. They never say Tower of Terror. They never say Twilight Zone. They just, like, what do they call it? Like a drop simulation experience or something. Like, they're not hiding the fact that this is a rebranding, but they're also being very careful with the way that they say it. And it was just an interesting video, I thought. The thing that scares me most is the turnaround time. They're saying summer 2017, and they're saying it's going to close early 2017. That's like 6 months. That's pretty quick, especially for Disney. So, I don't know. We'll see.
I'm excited.
Yeah. So what's the story is that Rocket, one of our favorite characters from Guardians of the Galaxy, enlists us to help the Guardians break out because they've been captured. How this fits into a drop story, I'm sure they'll work it in somehow. The cool thing is that we're finally getting our multiple different drops,
randomized,
different music, different actions for each ride. So that's cool. And they did mention that there will be opportunities to celebrate the Tower of Terror before it closes. So hopefully we'll get some like cool special events and parties.
That which is fun.
Yeah, you know, it deserves the proper farewell, I think. And I'm excited about it. And tell me if I made this up. I think I made this up because I went researching it and couldn't find anything. I could have sworn I heard there was going to be a Marvel dance party. I thought that they announced it as part of this, and I was like, maybe I just assumed that. No? Well, don't you think that's going to happen?
I think a lot of Marvel stuff is in the works.
Well, and they've said that, and they said there'll be more to come, more announcements to be made.
I've had arguments. People are like, well, it's the Hollywood Tower of Terror in Hollywoodland. And I'm like, well,
not for long.
It's going to get rebranded. Like, rebranding. The whole area is going to get rebranded, so it's going to make sense eventually.
Do you think we're going to get another rename for the park?
I think it's very possible.
Yeah, so that would be a third name for that park. Yeah,
that was another thing. People were like, well, it's California Adventure. I was like, yes, the staple of Bugs Land really fits into California Adventure.
Yeah, it's interesting. So I think I am excited. It took me a little while to warm up to this, but I think I'm excited for the change. As long as I think Tower gets the proper farewell.
Yeah, and it's not, I mean, we still have Paris and we still have Florida. Yeah, it's a trek, but if you really love Tower Terror so much, you'll jump on it in Florida.
And frankly, guys, I think if you're upset right now, you're really setting yourself up for disappointment. Because I'd say next 5 years, there will be no more Twilight Zone. I think they're all going to, not necessarily change the Guardians of the Galaxy, but I think they're all going to be rethemed in some way, shape, or form. That's my personal opinion, but yeah, so that's happening. Okay, moving on from there, we got some Disneyland announcements that I'm excited about. This has kind of been something, it's not really new news, but it's nice to officially get the word that the railroad and the Rivers of America will be reopening in the summer of 2017.
Woo!
This is great news. Now, this includes, so when we say Rivers of America, this includes Fantasmic, Mark Twain, Columbia, the Pirate's Lair on Tom Sawyer's Island, and
Fantasmic!
Didn't I say Fantasmic first?
Oh.
I think I did.
I don't know.
If I didn't, I meant to. No, and surprisingly...
You probably did. I was just really excited about it.
Surprisingly and shockingly, the Davy Crockett Explorer canoes. They're on the list. Like,
of course they are.
They're on the list to return. So,
I mean, what's the downside of not returning? They're literally just canoes. You have nothing. You have
less people to pay. I mean, they've got to pay people to run those things. And
people go on it. Enough people for sure. Those people to pay.
I guess.
And they have the canoes already.
Listen, I'm happy. I think it's great. I just think I'm a little surprised.
So what's better to say that Disneyland has 30-something attractions or 30-something plus one attractions?
I think it's way more than 30.
I don't know.
But,
trivia question.
But yeah, no, Fantasmic is coming back.
Woo!
I'm obviously excited about this. I'm a little bit scared by this.
Upgrades? Updates?
Updates, yes. I'm fine with updates. I'm fine with plussing. I'm a little scared of big changes. I mean, the most I want to see of Anna or Elsa is on the Mark Twain at the end. Like, that's the most I want to see of them. I've heard rumors, although really not from super... I haven't read it from any blogs or anything, but I've just heard whispers of, like, Pirates of the Caribbean replacing Peter Pan? I don't know. If they change the soundtrack, that's what's going to weird me out.
Mm-hmm.
And I know that that's a terrible way to be. And I should probably be more willing for bigger changes, but I don't know. It's kind of perfect.
We'll see.
We'll see. So Fantasmic is coming back.
Yeah.
Summer 2017. So that's when you all get your annual passes again, if you don't have them currently.
Yeah, we get... all that back and Guardians.
And Guardians, yeah. So
next summer
should be pretty cool.
And D23. Hello.
Oh my god. Yeah.
Lots of Disney.
2017 is a good year for a Disney fan. And live action Beauty and the Beast.
That's like March. That's still, like spring.
I don't care. It's 2017. It's a good year. It's a good year to be a Disney fan. So yeah, that's happening.
And Avatar.
Yeah.
Right? Avatar. December, like late 2017.
Yeah. That's the other coast, but yeah. Is it going to be that late?
I thought it was like that late.
Oh, they keep pushing it?
I don't know. I'm just making updates now.
Okay, cool. 2017 is the year that...
Star Wars Land's going to be done.
And Disneyland's going to get their version of the Carousel of Progress.
Uh-huh.
And
just going to put rumors out there.
Yeah, so. Another rumors episode. Start tweeting this, guys. 2017 Carousel of Progress. Nice. Actually, that could be terrible because that could be interpreted as something like it's going away or something, which we don't want.
All of Tomorrowland's going away.
What will we call it? Star Wars Land... Part one. Yeah, nice. Speaking of Tomorrowland, the Tomorrowland Terrace live acts are coming back for a limited time. I gotta be honest. I knew they were gone, but I didn't know they were gone. Like, I recognized, like, last several times I was at Disneyland, I was like, where are the 80s All-Stars? Like, I haven't heard them in forever. And I'm not sure why they went away.
I think they just did later Star Wars shows.
Is it... Oh, the Jedi training?
Yeah, I feel like that just went later. When Seasons of the Force opened, they just made extra shows.
Even like Into the Darkness? Although I guess the bands didn't play in the darkness, like their first sets.
They went late.
Interesting. Yeah, they did. They went late, but they didn't start late. So they were probably like, well, if we can't have them for the full set.
Yeah, exactly.
Interesting. Well, they're back. I'm excited for that. The 80s All-Stars I love. The Suburban Legends I really enjoy. And there's a bunch of other acts there. But it's going to be Friday through Sunday starting August 6th. And they did specifically say a limited time. So if you're loving these groups, I got to say go out and see them. Because I kind of feel like their time might be
going away. I feel like if you're going to bring those back and you're just going to have jamming on the bat lot happening, you could totally just bring Mad Tea.
Mad Tea Party? You just want that, huh?
Bring it back.
Which one would you replace? Jammin' on the Backlot or the Tomorrowland Terrace?
Both. To have Matt T.
Matt T in both parks?
No.
No, I'm saying if Matt T was going to take the place of one of those things.
The
Backlot.
Where it was supposed to... They still have the whole... everything set up still. They're like literally... It costs money to take stuff down, so they're just leaving it up.
Yeah, it's interesting. But I think it's going to become a Marvel dance party over there. Personally, I don't know.
Like, what are you going to...
What do you mean, what are you going to do? It makes as much sense as anything else.
But like... This is mentee.
Mentee's gone.
We can have like Iron Man singing.
No, please. You know,
I'm talking about a live band thing.
I just think like we'll have like superhero type of people as dancers and a DJ, and you know, I don't know if they'll necessarily be a live band, but
so like electronica but Marvel.
Yeah, kind of. Yeah, electronica but Marvel. Because electronica had Laser Man.
Yeah.
If you bring back Laser Man for the Marvel party, that is not hasn't been announced or anything.
I'm not counting Jammin' on the Backlot because that's not anything.
Okay.
But correct me if I'm wrong, since Mad T left, I mean, they used to have a dance party there since like 2009, 10?
What are you saying? There's been all different ones?
Yeah.
Yeah, it started with Glowfest, then it became Electronica, then it became Mad T Party.
Freeze the Night, and then Mad T Party Diamond, and then nothing.
Now the Backlot thing.
That's
yeah.
not a thing.
I mean, it is a thing. I honestly haven't seen a second of it. I have no...
It's not a thing. It's literally one DJ just playing music.
I don't even think it's in the program. Like,
no, it's just over the loudspeakers.
Yeah.
I think it might be on the timesheet.
Is it on the timesheet now? Okay. I feel like at one point it wasn't. I could be wrong, though. But in any case, if you love live performers, go to Tomorrowland Terrace starting August 6th on the weekends because their days might be numbered.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's see. Oh, great news. Great news.
Is it the news I'm no?
Is it the World of Color?
Yes.
Yeah, tell them.
So we all know Diamond Celebration is ending September 5th.
Mm-hmm.
And with that, Disney has officially announced World of Color Celebrate is leaving. But World of Color Original is coming back September 6th.
September 6th, yeah.
Woo!
Yes, this is good news. arms are still up. Yes.
So excited. Where's our little, like...
You want a confetti popper? I can get one. It's right behind me. Do you want confetti?
People,
let's do it.
Okay. World of Color Original is coming back.
Well, let's say this is for World of Color Original and Fantasmic. Okay.
It's like a little later, but World of Color, like no more Neil Patrick Harris.
No, point it the other way.
I don't know which way it
goes. Look at the arrows. You twist that one that way.
But does this shoot at me?
Oh, good. No, shoots out that way.
Oh, are you guys ready?
Okay, watch the microphone.
Oh, my. Yeah.
And wait, World of Color. Okay.
Wait, I forgot the music of original World of Color.
The wonderful World of Color. The wonderful, twist.
I couldn't do it.
Do it. Come on.
It's broken.
The wonderful world. My face of color. What? Do you want me to do it?
I can't do it.
The wonderful.
I wonder if everyone's listening, like, what is happening?
Do it. Just say it. Sing it.
The wonderful world of color.
Yay! World of color. The wonderful world of color.
Everyone's been wanting confetti.
There we go. We got a spontaneous confetti shot.
Because of world of color.
So that is fantastic news. That is confettiable news.
I'm pretty excited that since it's coming back, that means we might get like new segments, like a Moana segment.
Yeah. Well, they did say original World of Color. Do that again. For those of you listening, you just missed the most hilarious facial hand gesture by Patrick. Where he,
I was like real excited.
Yeah, really excited.
Like they can take Brave out and... Moana.
Yeah.
I mean, they don't have to. They can just add Moana.
I love
I'd be
it.
Fine with that, too.
No. They can get rid of Brave.
Yeah, like, because in the original, they, like, added segments at the end. Or, so, like Moana.
Yeah. Moana, for sure. Plus, I mean, Moana, come on, a lot of ocean, water,
hello.
Stuff. So, it's, like, just makes sense.
Yeah, get on it. It's this room. We're going to be, like, talking next week. And we're like, hey, World of Color is coming back with Moana.
It's true. And I think some of those other rumors we started, like the Carousel of Progress thing.
Coming
probably,
to Disneyland.
Yeah, it's probably going to come
as
true.
As well as the Scream ride and Alien Encounter.
Alien Encounter. We learned something interesting about that this past weekend. We went to the Midsummer Scream convention, and they had a panel about theme parks and scary rides and stuff. I had no idea that the extraterrestrial alien encounter was originally intended for Disneyland.
And not Walt Disney World.
Yeah, and that Disney was working on a Scream attraction.
And part of the alien encounter was the new Tomorrowland called Tomorrowland 1955 that never got greenlit because...
Well, not 1955. It was like 2050.
I thought it was like Tomorrowland 1955.
I can't remember.
Or Tomorrowland 55.
Something maybe something 55. Like that, yeah.
But Eisner shot it down.
Yeah.
So...
But yeah, it was a lot of interesting things. I had no idea that theme parks were thinking about Scream, which is one of my favorite franchises. And yeah, fun.
Interesting yeah. stuff.
Thanks, Midsummer Scream. It was a blast. But yes, so World of Color, it's back. Now on
September.
In September, yes.
Not yet.
I'm sorry, yes. It's coming back, I should say. Something weird happened at Magic Kingdom, and we didn't really talk about it because, honestly, I didn't think it was interesting enough to talk about, but now it's coming to Disneyland. And I guess the fact that it's bi-coastal now, it's coast-to-coast. Ding! Get it? Coast-to-coast? Mm-hmm. Yeah, you got that?
I still know what you're talking about.
Oh, okay. The pin
thing. Oh, the pin quest. Oh, my God.
Pin quest. Okay.
I didn't know it started over there already.
It already happened.
Oh.
It's like a one-day thing, I think.
Oh.
Okay. I think. Please correct me if I'm wrong. I know on June 30th it happened at the Magic Kingdom. It's going to happen at Disneyland on August 4th. If it's ongoing, I'm unaware of it. I thought it was like a one-day thing.
I don't, what a weird day. Isn't that like a Thursday?
Maybe it is ongoing. I don't know. Please write in. Let us know. Comment below. Or I can just Google it after this.
Yeah.
But Magic Kingdom, June 30th, Disneyland, August 4th. This is just... I'm not a pin guy. You kind of are.
Nah, just one set.
Okay. This is like extreme pin collecting. First of all, it's got this whole steampunk thing, which at this point...
Well, Walt Disney World is steampunk. We have a different set over in Disneyland.
Yeah, but it's still a little steampunky, I felt like.
I felt...
It's a little more
the pictures
more
I saw, it looked more Americana.
Okay.
Themed.
Steamed Americana?
No, themed.
Oh, okay.
While Walt Disney World was steampunk, this one was more Disneyland Americana.
What I'm hearing is in order to do the whole thing, it's about $80.
Whoa.
Yeah, because you've got to purchase a starter kit. The starter kit comes with, I think, one pin and a decoder medal and a map. Maybe it doesn't even come with a pin. But this decoder medal takes you to different areas of the park where there are cast members with pins, and you have to purchase cards at each of these locations. So you keep buying, and I think there's 6 cards throughout the day. You keep buying cards to go to locations to get pins. It's, I don't know who would do this. Like,
pin people.
I guess so, but that's crazy to me.
Yeah.
So you have to purchase 6 clue cards in addition to the starter kit.
I'm going to say no.
Yeah, I'm definitely not doing this. I just think it's... I'm a little surprised it was enough of a success at Walt Disney World to come to Disneyland. Because, to be honest, I feel like if it was going to be successful somewhere, it would be here more than Florida. But apparently it did well enough to come here. Or, I don't know.
So that's happening.
That's happening and happened. So... weird. Speaking of Carousel of Progress, something lovely happened to the Magic Kingdom's Carousel of Progress. Did you see
other what? Like what other one?
As opposed to the made-up one that we said okay. is coming to
like the Magic Kingdom's Carousel of Progress.
Yeah, yeah. Walt Disney's Carousel of Progress at Tomorrowland Magic Kingdom. It got a new paint job.
It got painted.
It did get painted, but and I know this is like not news, but it is news. This is an attraction that you know is kind of constantly rumored to be going away.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it doesn't even run all day, I don't think, right? Or at least certain times of year, it has specific hours that it's running.
Yes.
So the fact that it got a little TLC, I think, is just really good news. It's like bright, much brighter colors. There's a lot of orange, a lot of blue, but I don't know. I think it's worth noting. Yay? Confetti?
Yeah.
Confetti? Uh-oh, he's just picking it up now. That doesn't count. The people listening didn't hear that. Oh,
hold on.
Oh, he's going to scratch the mic with confetti. There we go.
You're welcome.
Thank you. So yes, that's happening. Some other stuff going on. Mickey's Royal Friendship Fair over at Walt Disney World is announced to be getting holiday updates.
Yeah.
I got to be honest, this surprised me.
Yeah.
Did it surprise you?
A little bit.
It surprised me because usually I feel like, correct me if I'm wrong, but I feel like when a show is new, they give it like a full year of this is the show. And then that's when they'll start adding on like Halloween, Christmas stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So the fact that I do wonder if this means it's not getting great ratings.
I hope so.
Do you still not like it?
No. Like, I mean, I don't hate it. It's just not Dream Along.
Wow. You just, the change is hard for you.
It's not Dream Along.
It's not Dream Along with Mickey, no. There's going to be different costumes and music for the final scene. And that's basically the difference. And they'll have like a Halloween version and a Christmas version. I was just a little, I was surprised.
I want to see the Halloween version.
Yeah, well, yeah.
I'm interested to see.
It should, you should be able to, right?
I don't know.
Probably, maybe, I don't know. It'll probably be early September, I guess. Patrick?
That's me.
Are you ready for some really weird Disney news?
Yes.
Okay. Disney is starting to track our footwear. Or I shouldn't. They have a patent to track our footwear in the parks.
Uh-huh.
This is weird.
Uh-huh.
It's a little disconcerting.
Uh-huh.
If you haven't heard, folks, Disney's going to start taking they have robots that will start essentially the way that a Magic Band tracks our every move. Now they're going to track our footwear. I'm still not 1,000% sure how it works.
Yeah, I'm like, can't you just track our movement with our Magic Band?
I guess not enough. I mean, I don't know. I guess it's for everybody as opposed, I mean, not everybody uses a Magic Band. I do feel like the majority do at this point. Yeah. This is weird to me, and it must be for something else. I mean, maybe we'll start seeing it like at resorts and stuff too. I don't know. This is very strange. This is really kind of Big Brother-y. I'm not the type to like freak out about that stuff, and frankly, I'm not freaking out about this. I just think it's weird, but I do feel like a lot of people are going to be turned off by it. And like, what if we have the same shoes on?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, what I'm wearing just all black shoes right now. A lot of people have all black shoes.
Yeah, I don't know. If they have face recognition, I guess shoe recognition.
Or like Disney Vans. Everyone wears Disney Vans at the park.
Oh. I thought you meant like a van you drive for a second.
No, Disney Van shoes.
I gotcha.
We're talking about shoes here.
I gotcha. So yeah, Disney was awarded the patent and their robots are going to start taking pictures of your shoes in the park. So maybe start writing like really weird messages on your shoes and like see if somebody backstage gets a chuckle.
That speaking of shoes,
yeah,
and I brought up Vans. I don't know if you saw, but there was a I don't know if it was necessarily a leak, but it hasn't been officially shown. But I don't, you know Disney Vans, right? They had like the Winnie the Pooh, whatever. Yeah. Well, they actually got into specific movies now, and they're coming out with an entire Toy Story line.
Oh, cool.
Of Disney Vans, and the coolest part is all of them say Andy at the bottom.
That's cool. Yeah. Nice detail.
So
nice.
I'm pretty excited. That, if you want to check out pictures of that, you can like Google Toy Story Vans. But they're rumored to come out in the fall.
I did think for a second, because I'm a nerd, I thought you were going to tell me they had Hocus Pocus Vans.
No.
And I got really excited.
That's a no.
But that's cool.
Yeah. I think it's interesting because they've just done general like Disney stuff. They've done Disney princess and Disney villains, but now they're like hitting a specific movies now. So I'm interested to see where else they go.
Which ones are you going to get?
Well, they have the normal, like, sublimation one where it's, like, one pattern repeated over and over. But they have a couple ones that are, like, a legit, like, Disney-bound shoe where it looks cool. Like Buzz's shoe.
Yeah.
So, I like those. And they have a green alien one.
I was going to say green alien would probably
They have
be cool.
a green alien one and the shoe glows in the dark.
Ooh!
The eyes. All the eyes.
Take that on a dark ride at Disneyland and you'll be very happy. Mm-hmm. Very cool. Oh! Oh, I just thought of something so cool. They might already have it. I don't follow the Van Shoes thing. Do they have the wallpaper print from the Haunted Mansion? Because if they had that with like the eyes of the Haunted Mansion and that glowed in the dark, it'd be amazing.
Yeah, they don't have a theme park line. Yeah, it's just like characters.
No theme park. Let's do it.
You should do a theme park line.
Where it's a rumor, folks. That's a
there
rumor.
That Van's Disney theme park line.
So in a week or so, that'll be true.
Yeah.
Yay. Cool. Are you ready for perhaps the greatest news of the week?
Yes. I already heard it.
You've heard it.
Is it a...
You texted me about it.
Oh, I did.
I lost my mind.
Yeah. If you don't already know, me and Jeff are big Newsies fans.
Huge Newsies fans. And in addition to Newsies, there's a particular cast member I'm quite fond of.
Jeremy Jordan. Who originated the role of Jack Kelly on Broadway.
Oh, so good.
Well, Disney decided, you know what, we should film... Well, like their tour is ending.
Yeah.
So they're like, you know what, we should film Newsies. doozies for question mark. I don't know what it's going to be for, but they're like, well, we're going to bring some of the original cast back. So they decided that they are bringing Jeremy Jordan, who was the original Jack Kelly, and the other girl.
Carol Lindsay.
Yeah, who was the original Catherine.
Yeah.
And they are filming it here in Los Angeles.
At the Pantages Theater, which is a beautiful theater. You have a ticket to the show.
I do.
Here's...
And the, everyone's been tweeting. I've been looking at Pantages Twitter, and everyone's been tweeting at them, and they've been saying no show dates have been released yet for this.
Which is a bummer.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. I didn't buy a ticket. I've been very fortunate. I saw Newsies twice on Broadway, twice at the Pantages when it came through the first time. So like, part of me is like, I don't need to see it again. With the Jeremy Jordan news, I'm like, okay. If I find out which show he's going to be... Because here's the deal, guys. I saw... It was April 30th, 2012. I saw Jeremy Jordan in Newsies on Broadway, blown away. Like, very rarely... Do you see theater that like blows you away? Like in the last decade, it was probably Newsies, Carrie the Musical, and Hunchback. Like that's it for me. In any case, after I saw him, I was like, okay, he was born to play this role. It just is a reality. He's fantastic. I bought a ticket to see him again before his year contract is up, December 29th, 2012. He left the show a couple months after to go do the TV show Smash, and now he's on Supergirl, and I do think part of the reason they're bringing him back and shooting it is because, like, he's a star now. Mm-hmm. So they're like, well, we can make money, whether they put it in theaters for a limited run, like through Fathom Events, or just put it on DVD, or maybe Disney Channel? Or there's also the whole possibility of, like, Disney is getting into that live musical TV game. And maybe their first...
Wouldn't be live, but...
Yeah, I mean, it would be live, and it wouldn't be live, but it would be live. So, like, maybe they'll introduce that to TV? I don't know. Regardless, they're not doing it for fun. So they're going to do something with this, and that's fantastic news.
Yeah.
I'm very excited, and I really hope they release the dates.
I know. I hope it's multiple dates, too.
I honestly think there's a very good chance he'll do the entire L.A. run, because it's less than a week.
Yeah.
And he's going to need to rehearse. He hasn't done it in well over a year. So, like, everybody coming back to the show is going to need to rehearse it. I feel like they might just rehearse it, shoot a couple of them with an audience. They'll probably shoot one without an audience for close-up shots and everything, because that's like what they did for Rent, their final performance on Broadway. And, you know, I would not be surprised if it's every show or most shows.
Yeah.
So
my only thing is, like, would they do that to the cast who's actually touring?
Yes.
Like, we know this is your last week, but we're going to give it to them.
Yeah. But I think they do have one or two cities after LA. I could be wrong about that.
I feel like LA
is it the last stop? Maybe.
Maybe. I have to look.
I wouldn't be surprised.
I'd be fine with that.
Or if the other cast has
bad, but
the other cast might do only matinees or something. Mm-hmm. Like, it's great news. Yay, Jeremy Jordan, who, if you don't know, is going to be a voice on the Tangled TV series as well. Yeah. So,
but they got to release it soon because at the end of this month.
I know. It's very soon. And I haven't, you know, I don't have a ticket. And I planned on trying to do the raffle, assuming the raffle will still be going, and win a ticket. But I don't know. It'd be okay if I don't see it. I'll be all right.
Mm-hmm.
But it would be nice to see it. So earlier we were talking about the Guardians of the Galaxy announcement, which was actually announced at Comic-Con, but there was some more Comic-Con Disney stuff going on.
Yes.
Moana had a cool panel there,
mm-hmm.
and they showed a lot of the film, from what I hear, kind of told with stories about. But the biggest news to come out of this is that Moana will not have a love interest in the movie.
Nope.
Which means lesbian rumors are going to start. Because that's how it works.
Oh.
Elsa's single, and those rumors start, so now Moana. But it's going to be more about the heroine finding herself. And so it should be interesting. I'm looking really forward to Moana.
Mm-hmm.
Anything specific from Comic-Con that you found interesting?
Not specifically from Comic-Con, but I know after Comic-Con, they did a press event for Moana, and they shared the short that's going to be before it called Inner Workings. I don't know exactly what it's about. It's called Inner Workings.
Mm-hmm.
So there'll be a short before Moana.
When you said Inner Workings, I immediately went to Inside Out.
So did I.
That's interesting.
But it's not Pixar.
Oh. Hmm. I was going to say, we could start that rumor. I was like, and then it'll come true.
Would they do a Pixar show in front of a Disney animation
movie? Sure, why not? You can do that. Okay. Inner Workings. That's all that they said was the title?
They showed it to the press people, but like, I don't know.
If it were Inside Out related, we would have heard it. Yeah. I know. So Moana's coming up. More movie news. Oh my goodness. The Rocketeer. Mm-hmm. The Rocketeer is getting a sequel reboot. Are you a Rocketeer fan? Tell me you've never seen it.
I've never seen it.
Oh, wow. Really?
Yeah.
Okay. I have seen it. I actually saw it. I saw it a long time ago as a kid, like on Disney Channel. Mm-hmm. Didn't really care for it. A buddy of mine loves it and says, you have to see it. So we watched it. I gotta tell you, not my thing.
To me, it just looks like Iron Man.
Well, that's actually part of the problem with it these days. And some of the articles I was reading was like they had that concern of it can't be like Iron Man. So they're having an African-American female play the role.
Oh.
Yeah.
So it's like the Iron Woman comic book.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Pretty much. God, I wonder when they read about that, if they're like, Oh, darn. Yeah, so it's going to take...
Like, Marvel did that with their comic book already?
Well, so I don't know. So, please, if I'm wrong, I guess write it in the comments. But I think what makes you the Rocketeer is the jetpack. I don't, like... It's not, like, a person is the Rocketeer.
Yeah, it's the same with Iron Man. Yeah. That's why it's an African-American woman playing that,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, so this is 6 years after the original. It'll be interesting to see. I don't know. I didn't care for the first one at all. So.
I didn't see it, so.
You're going to see it now?
No.
Yes, you are. You're going to love it. No, probably not. But yeah, if you're a Rocketeer fan, this is exciting news. And to me, all that this means is that Hocus Pocus sequel is like, boom, next.
It's the same. I recently saw the new Pete's Dragon, but we'll wait to talk about it after you see it. But I... Never saw the OG Pete's Dragon.
Are you the OG, folks? Do you think I'm going to see Pete's Dragon?
If you go for free.
Yeah, probably.
I'll tell you right now, don't pay for it.
Yeah, we'll get into it. Yeah. You really didn't like it.
We'll talk about it.
Okay, we'll talk about it on a later episode. Tease. But yeah, so Rocketeer, I think Hocus Pocus, start that rumor. Hocus Pocus. What could they call it?
Hocus Pocus Double Trouble.
Okay, I accept that. It's not great.
Two.
Yeah, because two. I think they got that. I think they're smart.
Hocus
Pocus Double Trouble. Start that rumor. 2 weeks. Within 2 weeks, they will officially announce that. What if it was Double Trouble? Oh my God. Would be crazy. Some more movie news. Meryl Streep. Meryl Streep, all you need to do is say that name.
It's playing Meryl Streep.
Meryl Streep.
In the movie Meryl Streep.
No, Meryl Streep is going to be in Mary Poppins Returns.
Yeah.
Which is fantastic news. I gotta tell ya, I read Saving Mr. Banks like years before it came out. Years before they even shot it. I read the screenplay, and the whole time I had Meryl Streep in my mind as P.L. Travers. Mm-hmm. So I just like this kind of like fits for me. I'm very excited. It's Meryl Streep. Can't do any wrong. So it's a good thing she's going to be playing. I read my notes and I took look down and I saw African-American female character from Rocketeer.
That's what Meryl Streep is going to be
and
playing.
And I was like, wow, Meryl Streep can do anything. That's amazing.
Yeah.
No, that was from the previous. She's going to be playing Mary Poppins' cousin Topsy, which I think is more fitting for Meryl Streep.
She can play whatever she wants to play.
I literally just cracked
myself.
Have you
seen Meryl Streep play a cat?
No.
But I want to.
No, okay. Which I'm sure she will someday. That was really funny. Yeah, she's in Mary Poppins Returns. It's official.
You know what she's playing?
Her cousin Topsy?
No, she's playing... Foxy from Spaceship Earth.
What?
The Foxy Scientist.
Oh, Foxy Scientist. Yeah.
In Spaceship Earth, the movie.
Yeah. Nice. Awesome.
That's what I want to see. That's her role.
Okay.
That's her role.
Okay. I listen, you can give Meryl Streep any role, and I accept it. Yeah. It's all good. Any case, that's all the news I got. You got anything you want to add this week?
I mean, we threw confetti.
We threw confetti. That's a good week.
Yeah.
We got rumors confirmed. That's a good week.
We got rumors started.
We got rumors started. Awesome. We got newsies with Jeremy Jordan being shot. We got Meryl Streep. Not shot, yeah, filmed. Well, videotaped, I guess. And we got Meryl Streep. Like, this
playing
is
whatever she wants to play.
Yeah, this is a very good Disney week,
yeah.
I'd say. But if that's it for the news, I think that means it's
trivia time.
Okay, do you want to hit me or shall I hit you?
Sure.
What does that mean?
Yes.
yeah, you're
I'll go first.
Okay.
So we're talking about The Rocketeer.
Oh, wow, all right.
Which I've never seen.
Yeah.
But do you know what year was released? Since we're getting a new one.
I would...
When was the original release?
I want to say like 1991. Am I close?
Is that your final answer?
That's my final answer.
That is correct!
Woo! Boom! So 2 years before Hocus Pocus and 2 years after Honey, I Shrunk the Kids.
Yep. It's a tentpole.
Yeah, it's a tentpole. Nice. Good. Wow, that was a good guess.
Good job.
Good job. Well, my question is years related as well.
1995.
Nope, that's wrong. We're talking about the Rivers of America coming back.
Uh-huh.
And really the only thing, when Disneyland opened in 1955, the only thing that you could do on the Rivers of America was ride the Mark Twain around it. All of these other things that have... What did you say?
Swim.
Swim, no. You couldn't swim. But all of these other things were added later. So... What year do you think the, at the time they were called the Indian War Canoes, and they're like, that's racist, so they went with Davy Crockett Canoes, Explorer Canoes, and Tom Sawyer Island Rafts. What year do you think that those?
Same year?
Oh,
or different years?
Those are the same year.
1959.
Nope.
58.
Nope.
57.
Nope.
56.
1956.
Okay, one
yes.
year.
Yes, 1956, so a year after the park, the Indian War Canoes and the Tom Sawyer Island Rafts opened, and of course, Tom Sawyer Island. What year do you think the Columbia made its way to the Rivers of America?
57.
Nope.
61.
Nope.
74.
Nope. You're going the wrong way.
58.
Boom. 1958.
That's what I said.
What year do you think Fantasmic opened?
Oh, I know this one. 19... 89.
No, that's the year of Honey, I Shrunk the Kids.
Yes, that's it.
No, it's later than that.
Is 92.
92, right. 1992 is the year of Fantasmic.
Because I was born during the first Fantasmic show.
That's not true because it opened in May and you were born in August.
That's also true.
So,
I was born during the 100th Fantasmic show.
Oh, well, maybe. I don't know. I don't know. Perhaps.
Because I was born in the middle of a hurricane in Florida, so they probably didn't.
You were born in a hurricane?
Yeah.
I was born in a blizzard. Oh,
storm babies.
Yeah, storm babies.
Is that a thing?
Yeah, it is now.
We have superpowers.
I think we should make t-shirts to say that.
Storm babies.
Nice. Awesome. Guys, that's going to do it for us this week. Of course, between episodes, you should interact with us in places like...
On YouTube. And on Twitter. And on Instagram. And on, you can listen to us on SoundCloud and iTunes, and you can like write a review on iTunes if you like want. But we also have a blog post on like on Tumblr, so you should like check that out as well.
Yeah, all that stuff can be found at DisneyCoastToCoast.com. We hope you all have a fantastic week, and we'll see you next time.
Bye.
Thanks for listening to Disney Coast to Coast. Have a magical day.
And that is rumors.
Rumors.
Rumors, rumors everywhere.
Yeah.
So, we're prefacing this with saying these are rumors that are going around the Disney Twitterverse and blogosphere and all that stuff.
There might be a Star Wars land coming.
That is definitely happening. Yeah.